Hi, it's Carrie with another 5-Minute Friday. In this 5-Minute Friday, we're going to search PubMed, and I'm going to show you how you can limit to Medline only or to PMC only. And I wanted to do this because I've seen a lot on Twitter lately about what's contained in PubMed, what's the difference. When you're searching PubMed, you are searching Medline, which is the major component of bibliographical literature contained within PubMed. You are also searching PMC or PubMed Central, the free open access archive of bibliographic literature. And you're also searching the NCBI bookshelf. So if we were to enter a search in PubMed, and I will just do something simple, endurance, TW, that's text word, and high intensity interval, TW, that's text word. These results, 727, are coming from Medline, PMC, and the NCBI bookshelf. Now, if I wanted to limit this to PMC so that I was only getting free full text articles, I can limit under text availability to free full text. We see already in our results we have free PMC article, but not on all of them. So if we limit to free full text, it's going to knock down our results to 327, and every article now says free PMC article, free full text. If we were to click on any one of the articles, the link to get to the free full text appears over here on the right-hand side. This may look familiar to you. So the article is here in its entirety, and there's usually a PDF available as well. Now let's go back to our results list. I've done a video on the difference between journals indexed in Medline versus journals indexed in PMC. But now we just want Medline. We're going to clear this filter. We're going to scroll down. Now I already have it showing up, but I'm going to show you how to get there. We're going to go to additional filters, go to journal. This is a journal category. PubMed used to have more journal categories like nursing and others. Now we just have Medline. So we have to select it and then click show. And then we have to select it again. So of our 727 results, 601 of them are coming from journals that have been indexed in Medline. Let's scroll down. You can see that there are also some PMC articles here too. There is overlap and that's totally reasonable. Let's click here on number 9. And in this case, we don't have that free full text link because it's not in PMC, it's in Medline. If it's in Medline, it also will be indexed with MeSH terms or medical subject headings. And we see that down here at the bottom. And if we wanted to try to get to this article, well, ideally we would have come in through our institution or organization. And you'll usually see a Find It link up here. If you don't have an institution or organization or you've just come in through the web, you can click on View Full Text and see if somehow you may be able to get to the full text. In this case, we have purchase info. Don't forget that if you're affiliated with an institution or organization, in most cases, you'll be able to do interlibrary loan where you request it through the library and they get it for you. So when you're searching in PubMed, you're searching Medline, PMC, and the NCBI bookshelf. In your search results, you can limit to PMC, you can limit to Medline only. And if you wanted to search the NCBI bookshelf by itself, you can do that. I've opened the page here. I'll put a link in the video description below. We can do the same search, endurance and high intensity interval. I put them in quotes because it's a phrase. I'll click search, and here we get 17 books that match our keyword search. And usually these are free to access. Let's click on one, Stat Pearls. It's going to show us the details of the entry, and if we click on the hyperlink, we'll get to that actual entry and be able to read it and see our keywords are popping up here. So remember that PubMed contains Medline, PMC, and the NCBI bookshelf. You can limit to either Medline or PMC easily in your results page. You can also search the NCBI bookshelf on its own. Now there are other ways to do this, but these are the easiest. Now I personally have no problem with searching PubMed and searching all of those components. That's my default. But if you are not at an institution or organization and you need free full text, you may limit to PMC. And if you are looking for high quality peer-reviewed articles, you might limit to Medline, especially if you're a student in school, because these journals have gone through a more rigorous process. And if we don't apply the Medline filter, we may end up seeing some questionable or low-quality publishers showing up in our results. Remember that not everything that shows up in PubMed is by default high quality, and you still need to use your critical appraisal skills. My default, PubMed, I critique everything I find, and that's how I do it. So good luck. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.